Hey guys, for the last 5 months, I've been applying a topical solution containing the hair loss drug Finasteride and leaving it in overnight. Alongside this, I've been using both a derma roller and a derma pen every 2 weeks, as well as a second topical solution of rosemary and peppermint oil applied twice a week. Every 6 or 7 weeks, I've been taking progress pictures. These are done soon after shaving my hair to 6 millimeters and under artificial light for optimal consistency. For those new to my channel and to my hair loss saga, I've been attempting to regrow my hair since December 2019. In that time, I have conducted 8 experiments on myself, though as my knowledge has improved, I can start to see some of the flaws in my earlier experiments. Other than some success with hair thickness using scalp massage, nothing appears to have worked so far. Some of the well-known remedies I've tried include ingesting pumpkin seed oil, stinging nettle root, biotin and saw palmetto, and 6 of my experiments have included the topical application of rosemary and peppermint oil. My 9th experiment was mainly centered around the topical application of finasteride. I'd previously tried microdosing and that left me with pretty bad insomnia, which disappeared within a week of stopping taking it. I'm since not convinced that the two were related, but I am still wary of the other side effects. Applying it topically is said to reduce DHT levels on the scalp to the same degree as taking it orally, while having a smaller but not negligible impact on blood levels, meaning fewer side effects. Plenty of you in the comments had been encouraging me to go for a derma pen instead of a derma roller, and I took this opportunity to do my first split head protocol. So the left side of my scalp was treated with a derma pen and the right side with a 1 mm derma roller. I was doing this every 14 days. In previous videos, I also mentioned the difficulty I had making direct comparisons between my progress pictures, given the variation in natural light, and that's despite aligning head angles and being consistent with hair length. The solution, starting from this experiment, was to take pictures in artificial light in my garage. The results are what I feel to be a very clear picture of obvious thinning at the crown. I did wonder if the contrast of what appears to be darker hair on the side of my head makes it look worse, but either way, this area here seems to be suffering from thinning. I'm going to bring in one more picture, which is what my hair looks like after 6 weeks of growth. This hopefully makes the current extent of my hair loss clearer. Sometimes a shaved head can be a bit deceptive, and this hopefully supports my decision to shave it as frequently as I do. What I believe my results show is that the concentration of finasteride I was using, which I'll cover in a minute, was not sufficient to encourage hair growth or even to prevent further hair loss. A quick word on derma rolling. It is mainly used to boost the effectiveness of other treatments, such as application of topical oils. So the fact I was losing hair on this protocol says very little about the effectiveness of derma rolling as a treatment. As for the topical solution, retail versions of topical finasteride are quite pricey, so I opted to make my own. Took me a while to source the ingredients, but with a combination of 96% alcohol, transcutol, and polysorbate 80, aka tween 80, I made a mixture which I could then use as a base with which to add my crushed finasteride pills. If you're lucky enough to live in the US, then the Minoxidil Max website sells a product called PG-free solvent, which can be used to make your own topical solution. The website Perfect Hair Health hosts a topical finasteride calculator. Based on my answers, it suggested a low strength solution equivalent to 0.1 milligrams per day, which I could apply with a 1 milliliter dropper. I was applying it to the whole top section of my scalp just before bed, donning a rather fetching satin bonnet to avoid getting it on the pillow. Absorption of topical finasteride is a linear relationship, meaning leaving it on for 8 hours allows twice as much to get into your scalp than at 4 hours, and I was going closer to 12 hours. If I were to repeat this experiment, I would probably double the dose, so having 2 1 milligram finasteride pills crushed for every 10 mil of solution and applying 1 mil per day. There are 2 reasons I'm not doing this. Firstly, the whole point of these experiments was to try and find something more natural that worked. And secondly, the warnings still make me a little bit uncomfortable, potentially having any kind of residue on my head. If you've never purchased finasteride, there's no reason you would have come across the information in the leaflet. However, I'm a little bit surprised that it isn't mentioned in more places online. It says it can be hazardous for pregnant women to come into contact with the drug if they're having a boy. Given that the solutions I've been trying involve either cutting pills and microdosing or rubbing crushed pills on my head, it all sounds a bit too risky. With the other warnings about depression, anxiety, loss of libido and erectile dysfunction, the fact that only around half the men who took it saw an improvement after 5 years, and for men over 40 it seems less effective on the temples, I'm far more comfortable experimenting with other solutions, even if it means I ultimately lose my hair. So within 24 hours of taking that final picture, I had my next protocol lined up and ready to go. It's a very simple one, and it consists of rosemary oil in a castor oil base applied every night, with derma rolling every 10 days. I feel like I've been recovering well enough from the derma rolling that I can push it from every 14 days to every 10. I'm also understanding more about the appropriate needle length, so I think a longer needle is appropriate when you're rolling directly onto hair, whereas if you're rolling onto scalp or very thinning regions, then you can probably handle maybe a 1 millimeter roller. You're doing it right if you can bring a general level of redness to the whole scalp. There may be some pinpoint bleeding, that's fine, but bleeding is not the goal. So far, I found the derma pen to be less convenient than the roller. It's such a small surface area that I find it hard to know if I've covered the whole of my scalp evenly. As for the oils, rosemary oil has been shown to be as effective as 2% minoxidil. Castor oil is mainly a carrier oil here, but it does contain ricinoleic acid, which is supposedly meant to improve circulation, and it does have anti-inflammatory effects as well. I've set this one up for 28 weeks, finishing in late September. I'm finding myself with a very short list of experiments that I still want to run, at which point I will just suck it up and go bald. Someone shared Scoob 3 in the comments. That seems to be quite an exciting one for the near future. I was also looking at Redenzil and low-level light therapy. Fingers crossed it will be the 10th time lucky and this series can end on a high note. As always, thank you for watching.